also in theaters in 2002 was The Ring, which is a damn scary movie.
Thank you.
It was a real spooky
movie.
The movie's real scary.
To this day, if I take a photo where like my face is blurry or one of my friends, I'm like, it happened. You're gonna die. It was 10 days, right?
No, it's just that Instagram didn't focus. I'm not gonna actually die.
No, it's fine, really.
Yeah, one of the important things that this movie did was sort of bring Japanese horror to the States.
Yep.
It sort of, it started that trend of a lot of remake. Yeah, it was a remake of Ringu, and in the following years, we had movies like The Grudge and Signal.
I feel like that's a good and a bad thing. Because a lot of the versions that we did here in the States are terrible. Yeah.
This was a good movie, though.
Like
this,
The Ring is excellent. Yeah,
The Ring is a great movie. Like, it wasn't one of those movies. It wasn't like a quick cash-in. And it did bring a lot of those really interesting sort of colloquial horror elements of Japanese traditions and culture to the American forefront, which I think has influenced a ton of horror that we've seen across all mediums since then. I mean, we saw stuff like, you know, this is... I think that the success of Ring is you can correlate that all the way to the huge boom that was P.T., and then eventually sort of didn't become Silent Hills. But
the sort of re-rise of horror as a viable genre.
Yeah.
Because, like, I mean, in the 90s, like, there were a couple of, you know, direct DVD slasher
flicks. Blair Witch was
the
big thing. Yeah.
Yeah. Wasn't that 2000, though?
I think it was the late 90s.
Okay, fair enough. Yeah. I mean, but still, like, you didn't really see, you know, actual horror movies. You saw, like, campy, wacky movies in the 90s. Like, you know, Jason Takes Manhattan and The Nightmare on Elm Street to the Million Times. And Jason in Space. Like, they'd become, like, a parody of themselves, and they were campy. But with The Ring and you know, maybe with Blair Witch 2, that really took horror and, like, be like, no. Like, let's make this scary again.
Yeah.
And people loved it.
Yeah. It really showed how scary little girls can be.
Yeah.
We already knew that.
The Ring, The Grudge.
Wait, should I not be kissing people upside down anymore?
Not little girls, but...
Yeah. Time out, both of you.
I love the conceit of The Ring.
Yeah.
And of just, you know, you watch this... It's something that could have happened to you. Like, hey, let's watch this tape, you know?
Oh,
and
yeah.
And you see, you know, this thing in the well, and then just your life just goes downhill from there.
Everything goes real terrible. Man.
And she was just so scary. And the way she moved.
Oh,
and that,
how they, like, remove frames of it a little bit.
Yeah. And she would, like, kind of jump. And I remember that when she killed the guy in the end.
Yeah.
Oh, man. I was just on my pins and needles. Yep.
That movie is PG-13. I think that's...
No.
Is it, it's crazy, right?
Really?
It's so scary.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
I know.
Don't take kids to see this.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
no, like, it's like, it's a common, you know, like, kids love things that are, like, forbidden. They're, like, they love, like, testing the water.
Yeah, sure.
Have been, like Bloody Mary, like... Go in the bathroom, turn off the lights, say Bloody Mary three times. When you turn on the light, that she'll be in the mirror.
Yeah,
it's like, there's this video, you're not supposed to watch it, but let's watch it.
Yeah.
That sort of, it just works really well.
Brian Altano's favorite scene are all those horses that die.
Oh, that
rules.
That almost killed the movie entirely for me.
Why? Are you a fan of horses?
I still haven't watched it since the first viewing.
Because of the horses?
Well, part of it, yeah. It was just like, oh my God, how is this happening?
I could not sleep after I saw it.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, it was at least a day and a half before I was comfortably able to be like, all right, I can be okay.
Yeah. And Damon, like you mentioned in our Pirates of the Caribbean talk, it's crazy that Gore Verbinski directed The Ring, and then the next year he had Pirates of the Caribbean.
Oh God, that's right.
Which is weird.
You don't see the natural transition?
Children's horror about children. Children's fantasy, actually.
Yeah, it kind of works.
Totally the same.
Yeah.